Guys, I'm Tom Alibrando with IWI. We're going to be talking about the Galil, how to assemble, disassemble it. We got a lot of questions of that here. It's different from an AK. A lot of people are familiar with the AK-47. So at the end of the day, they kind of put what they know about the AK into this. And most of that will work, but there's a couple things that are a little different, and we'll hit those differences now. So first thing you're going to do when you get your Galil, obviously verify no magazine in the weapon. Verify the weapon is clear. There's no bolt lock on it. So put the weapon on fire, pull it to the rear, weapon back on safe, yep, it's clear. The reason we do the fire thing is in a Galil, just like any AK, if for some reason the hammer is down, the safety is on, the safety will actually lock up the hammer. So when you're pulling it back, you won't be able to unlock the bolt. So you gotta put it on fire. If you feel that, rack it, put it back on safe, and then you're good to go. Bolt has to be in the forward position, obviously, to disassemble it. So the tab that we're gonna index right at the beginning is the disassembly tab at the rear, just like an AK-47. Weapon's on safe. I'm gonna push forward with my thumb and down into through the dust cover, the dust cover itself. I'm gonna grab the top cover. The top cover is wedged in by this extra steel here. It's to keep it tight inside the weapon because the rear sight assembly or optic is gonna be attached to the dust cover itself. So they want to make sure that it actually doesn't move and it returns to zero when you put it on. You're going to grab it, you're going to pop it up, and this comes off. You set it to the side, and you see how hard that was to pull out. Then I got to pull the recoil spring assembly out of the weapon. What you do is you're going to push forward and then kind of raise it up a little bit and then pull it out the rear, and it's a captured recoil spring assembly. It's a rod. It's actually a telescopic type system. So unlike an AK where you can kind of bend it up because it's a wire guide, you don't want to do that with this. You don't want to bend this. So I'm going to set that aside. Next thing that's going to happen is I'm going to grab the charging handle on the left side. I'm going to pull it to the rear, and the bolt assembly will come all the way out. And you'll notice that the actual gas cylinder starts to come with it. The gas cylinder, unlike an AK-47, you don't need a lever to pull it out. It literally just slides out the back. There's two small tabs on the rear part of it that fit into the receiver itself. It makes it for a good solid fit, okay? Now to remove the bolt, that's gonna be just like an AK. You're gonna push it to the rear, rotate it, and pull it forward, and it comes right out, okay? So you're all set. That's your field strip right there. You clean it, you're gonna put it back together again. And how we're gonna do that is we drop the bolt back in, and I put it in where it goes in easy, and I just turn it till it stops. That's the easiest thing you can do. You turn it till it stops, push forward on the bolt. Now the bolt in the forward position, it's locked. There's an actual lug that fits into a cutout groove that's in the bolt carrier, and it's gonna move back and forth in there and rotate, and that's what governs locking and unlocking, okay? I'm gonna grab the gas cylinder itself, and there's a little trick to this. So I'm gonna drop it down kind of where it needs to go, but I'm not gonna put it in all the way. Because the actual piston rod is longer, I'm gonna lift on up on this and kind of get it started. Now, once I get the bolt kind of lined up, I can drop the actual gas cylinder in, and the bolt has to be in the forward position. So what I'll do is with my thumb, I'm gonna push forward on the bolt so it stays in the unlocked position. Because if this rolls, it's not gonna go into the weapon. So again, I'm gonna get that started. I have to push down, push the gas cylinder forward. I have to push down against the hammer a little bit. There's a slot where these two grooves are gonna go into, right here. Those two grooves, the rails that fit into the receiver, go into that open area, and the hammer's pushing up on it. So drop it down, push the whole thing forward, and you're good to go, okay? Now this is where things are gonna get different from the AK. You're gonna take the recoil spring assembly, you're gonna push forward. Now, in an AK, you would put it right in the groove and then put the dust cover on top and kind of slap it down. That's not what you do with a Galil. This tab is a lot longer, and again, remember, the cover itself, the receiver cover, is very difficult to put in. It's gotta be very rigid and stiff, so it returns to zero and the optics don't change. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna push forward on the tab and actually drop down the recoil mechanism down into the receiver, and you're gonna see how it kind of slopes down, and that's what you want, okay? And it's outside of the tab. That tab, that rear locking area back there is now open. Grab the top cover, You drop it in and you notice there's a tongue on the front, and then there's a groove, kind of like a wood flooring kind of deal. You're gonna put it in, and what you're gonna do is, once this is aligned, remember this is a tight fit, you kind of chop it, you know, duty chop it at an angle, karate chop it at an angle, till it goes in. Okay, now it's in the receiver. I put my thumb on the outside to make sure it stays in place, and when I pull the charging handle back, if you look carefully, the back part of the recoil mechanism will pop out. Now the weapon is assembled. You're done, okay? And as with everything, you always wanna do a function test. If I take it apart, I put it together, I gotta make sure it works properly. So first thing I'll do when I do a function test, to clear the weapon, good to go, okay? Put the weapon on safe, attempt to fire, I get nothing. I put it on fire, I'm gonna press the trigger, I'm gonna hold the trigger to the rear, don't release it, because you're trying to make sure that the disconnector that's gonna reset properly. You don't want it to go into full auto when you don't want to go into full auto. This one is a semi-auto. The ones we sell are semi-auto weapons. Pull to the rear, let go, reset, click. I feel a hard reset. I know that the trigger mechanism, the weapon's working the way it's supposed to, and you're done with your function test. So guys, that's the Galil in a nutshell, assembly and disassembly. The little tricks there on putting it back together again, particularly with the gas cylinder and with the top cover. Hope that helps you, and look us up at IWI.us.